what we are looking at is, imagine an apartment 30 years from now. That apartment 30 years from now will be an apartment that already has a seaport and will be having the international community arriving. That's an apartment that will be part of the international community. Because of the seaport, you will be located on the global map because you have a port that they can say Port Akwaibom, Port Ibom Deep Seaport. You know, so you have that. And therefore, if you're ordering something from anywhere in the world, you're not waiting for that thing to arrive in Lagos. It's arriving in your backyard and you just walk there and you pick those things. Therefore, international trade, becomes easier. What will happen when the deep sea port starts out here? And from the day that deep sea port starts, from construction to execution, Akwaibom people won't be the same again. You go to the oil and gas free zone. Now, the people are asking, so what's happening? Yes, you've had the licenses. What is happening? The issue is that we didn't invite COVID. It happened. A lot of the things required in this in the construction are externalized equipment. They are not produced in Nigeria. So these things need to come in. So these things are not prefabricated. These are fabricated to, they are bespoke equipment.
Okay.
Uh-huh. So, and people can check Google about Bellore. These things are open. So in 30 years, the appointment will have, I hope that the people who will be governors in the next 20, 30 years will remember that, the man was in the economic foundation, that they will be enjoying them, because people said the foundation, when Chakwa Diako was setting the foundation for the Lagos of today, they had no position. He was buried a while ago, and everyone celebrated him, almost worshipping him. But Sammy, I tell you the truth, go and check Lagos. Jokande had opposition, great,
yes,
opposition,
yes,
in his time. But today he's being celebrated. So Udom Emmanuel has opposition, but I trust he'll be celebrated. Because when the fruits of the things he has planted begin to germinate and people begin to take those fruits, I only hope they'll remember to say thank God for sending a person like Udom Emmanuel. I drag you backwards to His Excellency Obomata. Recall that when we wanted to have site the airport, I keep saying, this airport that we all enjoy today started as a Bonanga project. And the man kept saying, look, I foresee a future. People said, why do you, on radio, people would say, why would you have an airport less than 30 nautical miles from another airport when the route to Calabar is good, you can simply go there. People said that. But today, what would have happened if Obomata did not start that airport? If Obomkotsulu Bodapadio did not do his part on the airport, and if Governor Udom Emmanuel isn't doing his part on the airport, would we be going to Calabar to fly today?